And welcome to our new tutorial, and we like to discover the effects in NETFLIX Arcane series and how to rebuild them in After Effects by using the plugin Potoon, which is available on aescripts.com. So let's jump in. First, import your footage into your project which you like to apply the effect on, drag them into the comp, and then you need I already did that, by the way. So this is a piece of footage from Arcane. And the first thing we need is a new solid. So go to Layer, New Solid, call that VFX, make it comp size and black background. That's important, and hit OK. So the first thing is we apply Potoon to that. So go to Effects and Presets, type in Potoon, and it will start with the checker pattern. And if you click on this checker pattern, if you don't know Potoon, this is a texturizing plugin with very cool features, and you can build your own texture library inside After Effects, so you have all the textures by your side. For example, this line scrubs here, if you click on that, you see the line scrubs. They are 4K, so let's go and scale them down. Go to Transform and scale them down to, let's say, 60%. And here you have your line styles, okay? And you can apply textures like that, and you can, of course, import files or show the folder in your operating system. And here you have all your bitmaps, your textures stored inside Potoon, and this is inside After Effects, and this is cross-project wise, so you have them always by your side, okay? So, to see what's going on there, we have to change two things. First, unsolo that layer, of course, and the next is change the transfer mode from normal to linear dodge and invert the pattern's style. So here we go. Now we have our line style on top of our footage. And so let's discover what's in the original thing. Okay, so we have this line style here. We will take care of this one here. And it swaps around each frame, you have another line style. And how to achieve that in Potoon is quite easy. You have a swap texture option here, and if you make this active and bring the swap frequency to, let's say, 12, then it swaps automatically over time. And it browses from all your textures inside this library folder. So you can put as many line styles as you like to into this folder structure, and it will browse automatically through that. So this is how you achieve this effect, which is quite easy and quite cool. So let's have a closer look, because if you look on this line styles, they are not 100% sharp as our line styles here. You see that? Okay. So how to achieve that? So go to in Potoon on your VFX layer, you go to a blur section and you can blur that. Let's say 5%, that should make it. And you see now you have it a little bit blurred around here, and that fits perfect to the original line style design. Okay? So now we are a little bit lighter than the original one. That is because of the opacity. And in the blend section of Potoon, you have an opacity channel, and you can bring this down to, let's say, 80. So now it looks much more better. Okay, so the next we like to take care of is this grungy thing here, these little grungy dots here around. Okay, so for that we imported a few grungy textures in our Potoon library. And before we come to that, let me showcase you how to recreate these line styles we built here simply in Illustrator. And if you go to Illustrator, as you see, we recorded, pre-recorded a few times this tutorial. Simply go, let me get rid of this. Simply go to your brush tool and draw some lines here. The best you do this with a pen tablet, but you can do it also simply randomly. Make your own lines, make your own line styles. whatever border you like, select that and try this or whatever you like, play with the size and save that as a JPEG, which is important. Go to export, save for web legacy, and then choose JPEG and save that, okay, into your folder. After you have saved that inside your folder, you can go to Patoon, to the texture, and simply import that, import the file, or go to your operating system and copy the whole export into your folder. You can rename that, you can call that line bold or bold lines or whatever you like to, and after that go in Patoon to settings, hit OK, and then it will reload, it recaches all the files inside Patoon. So this is how to rebuild the line size. Now go back to our little dots here. So as I said, I already have these textures done, so I go to Patoon, first rename that to lines, and then I will make a copy of that, string D on a keyboard, and rename that to grunge. Okay, and then click on my texture icon here and I will have this grunge lines. So these are our grungy line textures, and as you see, they are all over the screen, and in the original version it only happens here in the left side of the screen. Okay, to achieve that it's quite easy. You go to your VFX, make it draw mask, okay, and now you will see that this affects also the line style, so you don't have anything going on the right side. Okay, let me show you the original footage. Here we go. So the line styles are here. They are not the same opacity like the grunge thing, so we have to tweak that. First is, this is called mask. Let me rename that. And we call that mask grunge. And we will set that to none. Okay, so we have it again all over the screen, but we can pipe that mask into our Patoon texture layer. So, and now it affects only the texture. Okay, let's give the mask a feather, MM on the keyboard, and let's say 300 pixels should make it good. Okay, now we have a light feather here. For our artwork, I think it's better to have the grunge on the right side. So let's bring this over there and maybe a bit to here. Okay, so one thing to keep in mind, you see as I go with the mask layer over the line styles, they darken up, and this is because the blend mode from the grunge layer is set to normal. Set that to screen and now everything fits like it should be. Okay, so let's bring this mask back to over here and lower the opacity to, let's say, 15. I just want to have a little touch of grunge going on there. And because the swap texture is still activated, it will swap between all these layers. So that will look like this. Here we go. You see the swapping of the line styles, the swapping of the texture. That looks quite cool. Okay? So what is next? Next is, we like to have this reddish borders here. Okay, so for that, again back to my VFX layer, I have the grunge here, I have the line styles here, and now I need the borders. So I go to my grunge layer, string D on the keyboard, rename that borders, click on my texture icon and go to borders, and here I have a few borders. Okay, so this is how they look like. You see nothing because this is behind the mask, because we copied the mask grunge with us. So change that to none, and here you see we have here, we have the borders. Okay, so we'd like to have the borders on the other side, so let's rotate the whole texture to 180 degrees. So now we have the borders on the right side. I know original they're on the left side, but we'd like to have them on the right side. Okay, So let's have a look at our footage. We'd like to have the effects going on. So this is a black and white image. So we can tint that to, let's say, the skin color, the skin tone of this girl here, okay? So I go to the tint section and tint that to some kind of bluish, let's say, yeah, some kind of this one here. Let's have a closer look. Did not fit. Let me grab this area here. Yeah, that looks good. And bring it a bit, lighten up, so something like that. And let's bring the opacity tint to 100%. And you see we have that tinted here, okay? Let's play with the opacity here, because it's a 15%. So now there comes color into the game, okay? And because it is already swapping, we have the swap already animated here. Here we go. As you see, it's animated. Perfect. Looks very cool. So the next thing is we like to have some feathering edges around these borders, okay? Some very fine detailed things here, okay? To achieve that, let me make another copy of the borders, string D on the keyboard, and rename that to, how we call that, detail border. Okay, click on your icon and I go to blocks. I call the blocks and you see we have this detailed things here. Hold on. We have this detailed things here under the block. So let's bring the opacity a bit more up and you see it better. This is some kind of dusty looking thing here, which also swaps around. So let's bring the opacity down to, let's say, 40. Or let's try 30. It's just for a little touch of detail inside of this footage. Okay, that looks great. Okay, so the next thing, what is going on there is this glow here on the top, and I think it's done in post-production. Okay, so let's have a look how to achieve that. Okay, so I go to the VFX layer, or better, I make a new solid and call that shine. Again, black background, comp size, okay. And again, platoon to that. And I have some gradients, they ship with platoons, with platoon, and I'd like to choose this one here. And let me say the transfer mode to, let's say, screen. Let's say overlay. Here we go. And let's go to the transform settings and go to the transform point. And as you see, I can move that around here. Okay, and as you see, we have this corner here, and this is because of the scaling. Let's scale it up. Let's say 160, for example. And if we come over here, and we don't use tiled but mirrored, so, and we can animate that over time. So hit stopwatch offset, go to, where is it changing here, go to here and just move it over there so that we get much more light on her face. Okay, so That's the shine effect. You can animate if you like to the transparency. Let's do this. Go to opacity, a few frames forward, stopwatch 100% and back to zero. So now it fades in from here to here, which is quite cool. So the last thing we like to take care of is this organic thing here, this one, or we have it somewhere else. Here also this organic things here, how to achieve that. Okay, so let's go to our VFX thing. We'd like to have this organic thing on the left side, so let's go to our VFX channel, or let's make a new solid layer, new solid, hit OK. Let's rename that to organic, and again apply the tune to that. You can do anything mostly in one stack, but I like to separate that because I'd like to apply some effects after platoon to the platoon layer, and therefore I'd like to have a single layer. So I go to organics, choose this one here, and this is what I have so far. As you again see, it's not tiled perfectly, and this is quite easy to get rid of. If you go to time mode and set it to mirror, you have a perfect mirror here, and it won't be recognized in the comp. Okay, so this is one thing. So the next thing is, let me tint that, and let's have a look at our footage. Our footage is some kind of bluish gray, so I'd like to have the opposite color. So I go to tint, and this is the bluish gray, so the opposite was something about orangish, golden, like something like that. That should make it, and give it 100% so that we can see what's going on there. So this is what we have so far. Let's play with the transfer mode. Let's try overlay, try screen, much better. So here we have this thing going on. Next is we have to apply texture swap, and I like to have a frequency of 12 to swap these textures around, this organic one, and I like to have, of course, again a mask on that. We can leave it as mask 1, and we have to pipe that into our platoon channel. So next is I go to the mask feather, MM on the keyboard, and feather that to 500 pixels to get a very smooth overlay here. Okay, so far so good. Let's give him a little bit of style here. Maybe don't want to see this layer, just work on this here for now. And yeah, if you now go and put a glow on this layer, and let's bring the threshold down to something about 20, you will see it starts glowing here on these edges. It's a bit the same like here we go, but we don't like to overdo this, so let's play with the glow radius just to have some different lighting going on there in this threshold. Okay, so let's see what we have. It looks very cool so far. Okay, let's see how it looks all together. That looks quite cool. Here we have the rebuild effect, and this is the original one. So So what you have is this organic blends between. You see that? And then we have the change. So let's implement that also on our layer. So we are here, somewhere around here, we have the change. Let's hit you on the keyboard to see it. I think here it was, yes. And the next frame is, yes, here we go. So here we have to achieve this blending flashing effect. So for that, I go to layer, new solid, of course. Make it comp size, black solid, hit OK, and go again to my platoon last time. And I try to achieve that with the organic one. Let me see what we have. This looks quite cool. So let me have a look. Let's say invert. That's what we want to have. Let's say transform. Let's say mirrored. And let's tint that just a touch to some bluish gray here. Okay, and just a touch. That's cool. And give him some blur. Let's say 10. That's cool. We'd like to have this happen here. We'd like to have the swap texture on a frequency of, I want to have this for 2 seconds, let's say 3, so we make it 25, let's say 14, and let's see, and we go to here, hit the opacity channel, 100% on the first frame, 90% on the second frame, one more frame, let's say 70%, and one more frame all the way down. So this is how we look now. And as you see, it's not quite that what we want because it's too much white. So let's play with the transform mode. So if you now go and set that to add, that's how it looks like. And if you go to platoon back and bring the tint opacity down to 0, this is what you have. And this is exactly what we were going for. So let's have a look how the whole clip looks. Yeah, that's exactly what we were going for. You can compare this with the original. Here we go. We got a few things here. And one last thing, the eyes here, the little hearts, it's also quite easy to achieve. It's not part of the tutorial, but let me showcase you that in case you like to have this effect. Let's get rid of these VFX here and all of this crap. So we can leave that. Okay, so go and make a new solid. Call it heart or eye. Here we go. Comp size, black background, and again a platoon. What else? And then we have our, here we go, we have our heart texture. So let's go to the transform settings, go to the offset point, bring it to here, and scale it down. Of course, and you don't see anything, and that's because we have to invert the pattern's color. As you see, it's a black heart, and we invert that. Now we have it white, okay? So, and you have this offset button, and you see it tiles that whole thing. And if you don't like that, simply click single and you have that on your offset point. So means you can track that to a null. For example, if you like to track her eyes and then put that to in. Let me first set that to add. Here we go. So now you can put that onto her eyes. Okay, and track that if you like to. And to switch the hearts, it's again quite easy. Simply go to texture swap, make it active, go to 25, because we have 25 frames a second, so each second we have a new thing, and we simply draw this heart also in the Illustrator. And if you play that, you will see you got this effect with the change in heart here. Yeah, so you can do different styles, of course, and you can simply duplicate the layer and go and bring this other eye to here, and now you have two eyes, two hearts flickering around. And of course we have also a feature, texture driven. You can put on a flicker, make it active, and bring the flicker frequency to, let's say, 12, and now this eye too, flicker, active, frequency, let's say 13, so it's not similar, and now these eyes are flickering. Also, why they are changing their shape. Here we go. So it's up to you. You can easily link these textures to your transform position. You can track that, you can put that to nulls, and you will always have full control. And don't forget, it depends on your creativity, on your artwork, how to different paint these hearts or hashtags or crosses or whatever. I mean, you can simply animate on tic-tac-toe if you like to. Yeah, hope you enjoyed that tutorial. Find out the plugin on aescripts.com or in the description below. Don't forget to follow our channel for the next tutorials, and I will see you next time. Thank you. Bye.